सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis from around the world who are sitting with us at this moment in 712 places through NTV, 15 places in two-way connection, having Nayana Diksha in 206 cities in 27 countries. Today's subject for satsang is woman and spirituality. Women and spirituality. All the cities which are sitting in front of me now having Nayana Diksha two-way connection: Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Columbus, Phoenix, Pullman, Calgary, Toronto, Canada, Vancouver, Annanagar Center, Taramangalam, Guadeloupe, London, New Zealand, Paris, Singapore. Totally 16 cities from around the world are sitting with me. New Zealand and Redondo Beach. These are the centers which are sitting with us, having two-way connection. Live, two-way connection. My blessings to all of you. Before entering into the subject, I wanted to remind all of you to sit in Padmasana and Samana Mudra. Women and spirituality. By the nature of the muscle memory, women are hardwired for the major three qualities which can lead them to enlightenment quickly, which is a basic necessity for enlightenment: receptivity, passivity, and the ability for experiencing the feeling connection beyond logic. Please understand, receptivity, passivity, ability to feel connected, feeling connection beyond logic. These three is part of the very bio memory of female body. Women bio memory of women. Receptivity, the ability to receive The bio memory of the woman's body is not aggressive. It is based on receptivity, receiving. It is not based on violence. It is based on passivity. That is why sannyas or brahmacharya is a lot more easy for the beings in women body than in masculine body. Even if you are in masculine body, when you experience the enlightenment, physiological mutation happens in your system. You just go beyond the masculine, feminine identification and identity. Please understand, I wanted to make it very clear. It is such a subtle subject. Please understand, an enlightened being is neither male nor female or child or transgender. He is beyond all this. Something unique happens in his system. Already, I have done a lot of medical researches and experiments on my body. And I am continuing further more and more researches and experiments. I'll bring it to the world in right time, in a proper context, how an enlightened body is beyond masculine and feminine. Because during the enlightenment experience, the physiological mutation happens. Please understand, during the Satori, first experience, psychological mutation happens. And during enlightenment, physiological mutation happens. Because in masculine body, feminine consciousness gets awakened. It gets awakened so strongly, the physiological mutation happens. Side effects and after effects of the physiological mutation, only I have studied, for last many years I have studied successfully. Now also I am continuing to study. I will present to the world when time comes. I wanted to insist this one important thing. By nature, feminine biomemory, women's muscle memory is for receptivity, passivity, and feeling connection beyond logic. For enlightenment to be transmitted to you need to feel connected to something which is little beyond your logic. But masculine biomemory is in constant insecurity and fear. It is justified. Men say, no, we go out and do business and we are cheated, exploited. So we need to develop a shield of protection, security, and we need to think logically. Okay, it is justified. I am not saying your insecure feeling is unjustified. But what to do? Enlightenment happens only when you are able to feel connected. Maybe God has sent one gender to create infrastructure on planet Earth, one gender to enjoy enlightenment. Only one problem is enlightenment is eternal, infrastructure is ephemeral. But I tell you, God did not send any one gender only for any one purpose. Women can create infrastructures. Men can radiate enlightenment. Women have proved they can create infrastructure equivalent to men. But men have not proved they can be enlightened or experience feeling connection equivalent to women. Still, men need to do their homework. Even in our Sangha, I can see people are experiencing Kundalini awakening. It is not that I bless only that side. I bless both sides. By nature, their system is built for receptivity, passivity, and feeling connection beyond logic. Men also carry the quality when they were kids, but the interest and the interest they have to get conditioned by society automatically reduces them to an ordinary. Please understand, ordinary. Insecure. Confined to logic. Women, by nature, have the extraordinary capability to feel connected beyond logic. Men should evolve in that direction, should create those higher qualities to achieve and experience and express enlightenment. Receptivity, passivity, feeling connection beyond logic are the basic requirement for you to radiate enlightenment, the complete fulfillment. When you are receptive, passive, just simple nature can give you enlightenment. River can talk to you. Hill can initiate you. Ocean can fill you. See Ramana Maharshi. Even Ramana Maharshi became intensely feminine. That's the reason Arunachala initiated him into enlightenment. If you see his marital garland of letters in Mathura Bhava, he just radiates that feminine consciousness in the mood of being receptive to Mahadeva Arunachala. Almost all the great masters who experienced the highest consciousness radiated extraordinary feminine qualities. Yan Kriya is a powerful technique to awaken your Kundalini and make you experience receptivity, passivity, to experience the feminine consciousness and reach enlightenment. Jainism says even women have to take birth as men to achieve enlightenment. I am saying even men have to get into the feminine consciousness to achieve enlightenment. Men may not need to take women's body, but they have to get into feminine consciousness to achieve enlightenment. Jainism says women need to take one more birth as a man in masculine body to achieve enlightenment. I tell you, men need to take one more psychological rebirth into feminine consciousness to achieve enlightenment. I bless you all. Let you all experience highest spiritual experiences and powers. Already many disciples, devotees have received vibhuti and kumkum in their hands. Nitidevi has received vibhuti and kumkum in hands and face, all over the body. Can you project? And Seremban Center in Malaysia is receiving vibhuti. My blessings to all of you. And Dr. John, who was doing the scientific research, is really excited and very happy about the results he found now. He sent a message. He will thoroughly analyze the data and give us complete feedback in scientific language. My blessings to all of you. All the devotees who came for Kalpataru and Enwealth program, please don't stand in Sarvadarshan. Go for your breakfast. Kalpataru darshanathirkagavum, Kalpataru nigatchikagavum, Enwealth nigatchikagavum vandirukkum bhaktargal darshanathirkaga nirka vendam. Ippozhudhu sarva darshanathirkaga nirka vendam. Ningal ungalude kaalai unavukkaga sellalam. Sarva darshanathirkaga mattum vandirukkum makkal sarva darshanathirkaga nirkalam. I bless you all who are sitting with us at this moment in 896 places through NTV. And in 19 places, two-way connection having Nayana Diksha. In 245 cities in 32 countries. I bless you all. My special blessings to all the cities which are having Nayana Diksha. I bless you all to achieve, experience, live, express, radiate and share the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
Yeah. Jesus.